From giant snakes and wild hogs to iguanas and killer crocs, here are 14 of the most invasive species in Florida. Number 14, coyotes. These canines have been found in all 67 counties of Florida and arrived as a result of their range naturally expanding from the west. These animals are very adaptable and can be found from urban areas to rural landscapes. They've been known to kill cattle in Apopka and have proven to be a danger to house cats that are left out at night. But many experts say coyotes help to maintain a balanced ecological system because they prey on rodents, insects, and other small animals. That helps to keep the populations of those pests under control. Number 13, nine-banded armadillos. Mention armadillos and you'll probably think of the southwestern US, but these armored animals are found almost everywhere in Florida these days, and they've been there for quite a while. Experts say that they wandered in from western states and made it to Florida at some point during the late 19th century. Today, they are firmly entrenched there. Nine-banded armadillos have the greatest distribution of any armadillo and are found in North, Central, and South America. Number 12, common caiman. The smaller size of these reptiles made them attractive to owners seeking to replace their pet alligators after keeping them was banned in parts of the US. Like many exotic species, they were released into the wild by their owners after they grew too large to care for. Breeding populations are entrenched in Dade and Broward counties and have been sighted as far north as Sanford. While they're considered to be harmless to humans, experts say that the caimans can carry parasites that could have a negative impact on ecosystems. Number 11, red lionfish. These venomous marine fish are known for their striking colours and are native to the Indo-Pacific. This species has become invasive along the eastern coast of the US and in the Caribbean. Experts think that the creatures were introduced to the Sunshine State in the mid-1990s when Hurricane Andrew destroyed an aquarium in South Florida. Many others were discarded by unhappy aquarists. However they got there, the animal's population continues to expand, with some areas in Florida reporting a 700% increase. Number 10, kill the croakers. Cane toads got their nickname when farmers in Australia introduced them to eradicate regional pests found on sugarcane. Instead, they became a nightmare here in Oz, and their numbers are now in the billions. They aren't as numerous in South Florida, but they were introduced there for similar purposes, and there was a similar result too, with their populations booming. The critters are big, weighing 2 pounds or 1 kilogram, and measuring 8 inches long, that's 20 centimeters. They also have some big appetites, which endanger many native species. How serious a threat are they? Florida wildlife officials recommend that residents kill the animals on site. Number 9, Fishzilla. The northern snakehead fish gets that nickname thanks to their large size, growing to about 4 feet long or 122 centimeters. And they have some unusual abilities, like living for several days without water and migrating over land for short distances. Native to China, they first appeared in US waters around 2002 and now occupy 3 counties in Florida. Their voracious appetite leads to indigenous populations of wildlife being eradicated. The threat is so severe that in some parts of the country, the fish are grouped in schools and electrocuted in the water. Number 8, far from home. State wildlife officials were presented with a mystery when they found 3 Nile crocodiles in the marshes of Miami-Dade County. That's about 6,000 miles or nearly 10,000 kilometers away from their home in sub-Saharan Africa. It also presented officials with a troubling scenario. Crocodiles in the wild have great success, and these animals are notorious for being fast, strong, and aggressive beasts. Their presence is viewed as a threat to local populations of crocs and gators, and in their native lands, these predators have been known to go after humans as well. So far, it's not known how many Nile crocs might be living in Florida, but most wildlife biologists agree that it's more than the 3 that were captured. Number 7, here be dragons. an Asian water monitor measuring some 6 feet long or 2 meters, made news in 2018 when it terrorized a family in the town of Davie. While the enormous creature was sighted on their property for several days, it was never captured despite the efforts of trappers. But it's proof that yet another species of big reptile has decided to call Florida home. Wildlife officials say that various species of monitors have been sighted across the state. Breeding populations of West Nile monitors are known to be established in several counties of South Florida. Did you know these animals are related to the Komodo Dragon of Indonesia? Those are the world's largest lizards at some 10 feet long, 3 meters and 150 pounds or 68 kilos. The good news is that those particular beasts haven't showed up in Florida. Not yet, anyway. Number 6. Argentine tegu lizard. It's a black and white reptile that can weigh around 30 pounds or 14 kilos and measure 4 feet long or 122 centimeters. Going with that size are some strong claws and sharp teeth. They've been breeding throughout the state after having been released into the wild. In the Ocala National Forest, more than 100 sightings of the lizards have been reported. Since the climate is similar to their native South American habitat, they can easily adapt and rapidly reproduce. Due to that, the animals can pose an ecological threat as they compete with indigenous species for food and space. Number 5. Monkey business. Rhesus macaque monkeys can weigh about 17 pounds or 8 kilos and are identified by their pink faces. Native to Central and Southeast Asia, they are listed as a globally invasive species. In the US, the animals are thought to have been released or escaped into the wild after zoos or wildlife parks were destroyed by hurricanes. In one documented case from 1938, a colony of rhesus macaque was released into the wild as part of a tour cruise promotion in Marion County. They've since been sighted as far as Seminole and Orange counties. The highly intelligent and aggressive animals can force out many native species, and because they carry transmittable viruses like herpes B, they could pose a danger to humans as well. Number 4. Green iguanas everywhere. These lizards have more in common with humans than you might think, and that's especially true in South Florida. Iguanas enjoy the nice scenery and swimming pools where they're often found. They've also been known to hit the links at golf courses and are commonly seen around pedestrians on sidewalks. At around 5.5 feet long, or 1.7 meters, and weighing 9 pounds, 4 kilograms, the reptiles have been breeding rapidly in the areas where pet owners dump them. That includes Miami suburbs and the Keys, where packs of them swarm over seawalls and leave behind trails of filth as they roam through parks. Many citizens complain that there's just no escaping these cold-blooded critters, which continue to multiply like rabbits. If you've ever encountered one, tell us your story in the comments below. Number 3. Wild hog heaven. Only Texas has more of these wild porkers than Florida. Also known as feral hogs, these beasts have occupied areas of the Sunshine State since being introduced by the Spanish in the 1500s. There are thought to be more than 500,000 hogs roaming about, and they can leave a lot of ecological damage in their wake. Experts say that they will take any food set out for wildlife or livestock and destroy forests or plantations by gobbling up tree seeds and seedlings. Another concern is that the hogs can serve as carriers for pathogens including cholera, tuberculosis, and anthrax. And they're not shy about confronting humans either. More than 4 deaths have been attributed to wild hog attacks. Florida fish and wildlife officials have targeted them as some of the state's most problematic wildlife. Number 2. Burmese pythons squeeze Florida. After a brief time out for those porcine mammals, we're back to the invasive reptiles. This is one of the Sunshine State's signature invasive species. They first started showing up in the 1980s and their population has ballooned ever since. With many of them now found in the Everglades, these serpents have been taking out native animals like raccoons, possums and squirrels with a Terminator-like efficiency. The threat to indigenous wildlife is so severe that the state authorized a hunting program to control the numbers of this beast. While the program has resulted in the extermination of around 1,000 pythons, there could still be 100,000 of the animals living in the wild. Number 1. Jolly green anacondas. In addition to those Burmese pythons, even more of the world's largest snakes have taken up residence in Florida. Green anacondas have been found slithering through the Everglades, but most of the ones captured have measured around 9 feet long or 2.7 meters. Those specimens were probably juveniles, because a mature anaconda can measure more than 17 feet long, 5.2 meters, and weigh over 150 pounds, that's 70 kilograms. With these beasts in the picture, local ecosystems could be turned upside down as the serpents usurp gators and bobcats as the region's top predators. Are there any more invasive species in Florida that we've missed? Let us know in the comments. Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit that big red subscribe button and click the bell for notifications for our next episode here on Epic Wildlife.